All right, one of the government's most important jobs, keeping us safe. That means catching terrorists in their tracks before they attack. But General Martin Dempsey, chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff, says we've got a long way to go.
We try to keep pressure on that network with the suite of capabilities that we have, whether it's intelligence, building partners, in some cases direct action.
Do we need to do more?
Well, I think so, absolutely.
So what's getting in our way? Islamic terrorism expert Douglas Murray says we've sidelined the only system that works. So what is that system, Douglas?
Well, good to be with you. The problem is that Paris shows that the terrorists can get through. Of course they can. There is no fail-safe way to stop them. They will always be lucky at some point. But I do think that what we've seen in recent months and arguably years, from the US in particular, has been a succession of shots in our own feet in terms of our own capabilities. We've seen the devastating Snowden leaks, which revealed to all the world how your government agencies and my government agencies collect information that immediately weakened one of the only, if not the only, advantage we have, which is to stay one step ahead of the terrorists. And that capability has been, as the head of MI5 said in a speech just last week here in London, dramatically weakened by those revelations. But there's been a whole set of such things. You know, you recently had the report on the CIA, the majority Democrat report in the US. All of these reports, one by one, these leaks, turned the general public, in my view, into thinking that the security services, the only people keeping us safe, are in fact our enemies.
It's unbelievable. They're making the CIA, the MI5, seem like the bad guys, as if we're being intolerant, causing this terrorism. Prior to that, the thing was, well, if the U.S. didn't have bases in Saudi Arabia, there wouldn't be an issue. That turns out to be a farce. There's more bases, Douglas, around the world of terror than ever before, including ISIS. They have a virtual country.
Yeah, no, they do have. They have a bit of two countries under their control. We said after 9/11 that ungoverned spaces were the problem. Look around the world today. It's absolutely covered in ungoverned spaces where terrorists can train.
Yeah, and real quick, what changes? What changes today that wasn't like this last Tuesday?
Look, I wouldn't get hung up on the protests in Paris. Yes, it's very moving, very important, and so on. But actually, most of the world leaders who turned up, if Charlie Hebdo had been publishing in their countries, they would have dismissed the publishers as Islamophobes, far right wing, and so on. They would have probably tried to close them down in most of those countries, including free democratic countries. The fact is that there's an enormous hypocrisy going on here. We are at a war with radical Islam.
Right.
Your government won't admit that. And actually, the previous government in the United States wouldn't admit that. The Bush administration wouldn't admit that. We are collectively cowed, and we are losing.
Gotcha. Douglas Murray, the guy who tells it like it is, an Islamic terrorism expert, and he will say that. Douglas, thanks so much.